The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. This is Father John Zulsdorf. Each day during Advent, I'm offering a 5-minute podcast to help you in your observance of this important liturgical season. Advent is a time to prepare for the coming of the Lord. From Daughter Zion by Joseph Ratzinger. The determination with which nowadays Jesus' birth of the Virgin is rejected cannot be explained by pointing to the historical problems. The real and sustaining reason inspiring the historical questions lies elsewhere, in the difference between our worldview and the biblical account, and in the notion that the latter has no place in a world determined by natural sciences. Any worldview is always a synthesis between knowledge and evaluation, and in this indeed lies the problem. Regarding the tenets of our worldview that would psychologically compel us to declare the virgin birth an impossibility, it is clear that this is not a result based on knowledge but on evaluation. Granted, a virgin birth now as then is improbable, but not at all simply impossible. There is no proof of its impossibility, and no serious scientist would ever assert there is. By no means are we thus dealing here with incidentals, but with the central questions. Who was this Jesus? Who or what is man? And ultimately, with the question of all questions, who or what is God? This question, in the last analysis, decides the definition of what man is. Even an atheistic conception of man, by way of denial, is determined in its question about man by the question about God. The testimony about Jesus' birth of the Virgin Mary is not merely some fringe devotional corner in the context of New Testament faith. It is not merely the private little sanctuary of two gospel writers, easily and without loss dispensed with. Rather, we touch here on the question about God. Is God, somewhere, a deep dimension of all being, holding up everything like buoyant water, as it were, with no one knowing how? Or is he the one who acts, who has power, who knows and loves his creation, is present to it and active in it, forevermore, even here and now? Natus ex Maria Virgine is in its core a theological statement. It testifies to a God who has not abandoned his creation. On this is based the Christian's hope, his freedom, his serenity, and his responsibility. There is naturally in every man a desire to know. But what profiteth knowledge without the fear of God? Better of a surety is a lowly peasant who serveth God than a proud philosopher who watcheth the stars and neglecteth the knowledge of himself. He who knoweth himself well is vile in his own sight. Neither regardeth he the praises of men. If I knew all the things that are in the world and were not in charity, what should it help me before God, who is to judge me according to my deeds? Rest from inordinate desire of knowledge, for therein is found much distraction and deceit. Those who have knowledge desire to appear learned, and to be called wise. Many things there are to know, which profiteth little or nothing to the soul. And foolish out of measure is he who attendeth upon other things, rather than those which serve to his soul's health. Many words satisfy not the soul, but a good life refresheth the mind, and a pure conscience giveth great confidence towards God. Thomas A. Kempis. Thank you for listening. I'll be back tomorrow with another Advent cast. In the meantime, please pray for me as I will for you.